So what qualifications do you need to become a pathologist assistant? Now, typically you will require some kind of certification from a national body. If you are Canadian, that would be from the CCCPA or Canadian Certification Council of Pathologist Assistant, or in the US, that's the ASCP, the American Society of Clinical Pathologists. Certification is optional. However, a lot of employers will only choose to employ PAs who have this type of certification. And in order to get those certifications for both CCCPA and ASCP, you are required to graduate from a NACLS accredited PA training program, and there are about 12 or 13 of those currently in North America. There are new schools popping up here and there, but if you go to the NACLS website, I'll put a link down in the description that you can check out. A link through there will show you all the accredited training programs both in Canada and the US, and those are two-year master's degrees. Once you complete those training programs, you'll have to write a certification exam following that, either for Canada or for the United States, to become a certified pathologist assistant. Now, typically, if you are applying to one of the training programs listed on the NACLS website, the qualifications or requirements for entry to those programs can vary program by program, but generally speaking, you'll need a sciences bachelor's degree, something like a Bachelor of Health Sciences or Bachelor of Biological Sciences, or something that also fulfills that science requirement. From there, some of them will require courses like anatomy, physiology, histology, some science courses like basic bio and chem, organic chem, and inorganic chem. Again, that varies from institution to institution. GPAs may range from high twos, so like 2.8 to 3.3 as a minimum entrance GPA. Other requirements for these schools are shadowing hours. They may require you to have 5, 10, maybe up to 40 shadowing hours before they'll accept you. Some references, usually 2 to 3 references. And then they might be looking at your work experience if you are a mature student, or perhaps even volunteer experience if you don't have an extensive work history. And then from there, it's off to the races. Once you get into a training program, you'll have 2 years to complete that master's degree. After completing that, you'll be eligible to write one of the certification exams. And then you'll be a fully certified pathologist's assistant.